Hey guys, the Blue Umbreon here, and this is going to be a discussion video of what I want to see happen in Black Ops 2. So before we get to this, I'm just gonna say what I really don't like that they've done so far with this game, and that would be the futuristic setting, because I think that's just what Infinity Ward does, and Infinity Ward's games are okay. I can play them and still be fine with them, but I like the idea of a war that's actually happened in the past, like Treyarch usually do, World War II, Cold War. I just think it's more interesting that way. So, now that that's out of the way, here is my wish list for Black Ops 2. So first, I really, really hope that they include, like, flashback missions, so that's not too repetitive. Like, I thought Modern Warfare 2 and 3 stories, they were just very repetitive. That's my opinion, though, so. And also, in Modern Warfare 3, I noticed one detail at the end of the game that was from Black Ops' last mission. So, in Black Ops, you choke Dragovich at the last mission. I'm sure you all remember that. And the same does happen with Makarov, but the only difference is that that does not kill him. He actually gets hung at the end. I'm sure you all know that too. If I did, too late. Either way, Infinity Ward, I think Infinity Ward just ran clean out of ideas and decided to steal the Black Ops ending and just change it up a little bit, but that's just me. And now anyway, I want to address what I would like to have in Zombies. So obviously I want them to include all the old maps like Kino or Darius 5, you know, those maps. Or I would just remove it from Black Ops 2, and then they could make a standalone game for Zombies, include all of the maps from World at War, all the maps from Black Ops, and then just add more and more every few months. And then another thing I want to see in Zombies is a better AI, because right now all they do is run towards you, and it's not as realistic. So I think maybe if they like hide in a specific spot and they can ambush you, it would be much more fun and challenging than what it is now. I mean, it is challenging now because I suck at it, but it will be even more challenging then, which makes it more fun in the long run. So the biggest aspect of the game, which is multiplayer, obviously. And I think for the past few games, there were just too many unbalanced guns, perks, killstreaks, and everybody hates these death streaks. Like, some death streaks are okay, like Juiced and Copycat. I don't know why people hated Copycat so much, but I thought it was just fine. But the worst death streak is just Dead Man's Hand. I hate that death streak so much. So they removed death streaks in Black Ops. So I expect the same for Black Ops 2. They might add them in, and hopefully that does not happen. And some of the game modes in Modern Warfare 3, I really have come to like Kill Confirmed and Infected. I wish they would add those in as well. So for the guns and kill streaks, I just hope that they equal out the stats for each gun so that they're not too far apart, so nobody can say, oh, this gun's overpowered, and sorry guys. I hope that they make the stats equal, as I just said, and this, obviously, the same cannot be done with killstreaks, because the higher killstreaks mean the better damage or better radar, like the UAV is standard UAV. You only see them for a few seconds per few minutes. And the SR-71 is constant. That was in Black Ops. So one is okay, but then one is completely OP. However, they can weaken the kill streaks so that they're not as deadly as in the other games. Like the Reaper in Modern Warfare 3. If somebody really knows how to use that, they can use that and get plenty of kills. And good players, they usually stay good or get better in the next game. Whereas bad players, like me, usually stay just as bad or get worse at the next game. So that just seems to be the case for me. I don't know about any other players out there. But the last thing I want to talk about are the perks, because some of the perks just kind of ruin the game for some people, like Ghost. Like Black Ops, I got an attack helicopter once. It didn't even get one kill in the entire duration it was out, and I'm thinking that most of them were using Ghost Pro, which is makes you undetectable by air support minus the SR-71. And that was just the most overpowered, overused perk in my opinion. And well, that's all I really have to say for Black Ops. So enjoy the rest of the gameplay. See you guys next time. Blue Umbreon is out. Strike.